Hi, it's been a while, right? Today is the day after 4th of July. It's a good weather outside. So we're planning to grill baby back rib for dinner. Normally, people eat ribs with cornbread. So I'm going to make cornbread. It's gonna be buttermilk cornbread. But to make buttermilk cornbread, you need to use the actual buttermilk. This, okay? Not the buttermilk that you make yourself or homemade buttermilk. If you do not have buttermilk, then you can just make the regular cornbread with whole milk. All right, first, I am preheating my oven to 375 degrees Fahrenheit. To make cornbread, of course, we need cornmeal, right? We have two kinds of cornmeal here, the yellow cornmeal and the white cornmeal. I'm using the yellow one. And like I said, I'm going to use buttermilk. So the buttermilk and the eggs for cornbread, they have to be at room temperature. Besides cornmeal, we're gonna use all-purpose flour as well. Okay, so 1 cup of cornmeal and 1 cup of all-purpose flour. And we're gonna use salt, sugar, and honey. So the combination of the buttermilk and the honey is gonna make the cornbread not crumble when you bite and not dry. Okay, so first I'm going to mix the wet ingredients. Okay, I need a large mixing bowl and I'm going to put my 1 stick or 8 tablespoon of unsalted butter here. It is melted unsalted butter into my large mixing bowl. Add 1/4 cup of honey. All right, and also the 1/2 cup of granulated sugar. You can actually mix this sugar together with your dry ingredient, but because I'm going to mix it with my hand mixer, so I'm gonna just add it here. All right, so we're gonna mix these three things with mixer, hand mixer. If you want to use your hand whisk, go ahead. Just mix until they are combined. All right, now I'm going to add the eggs one at a time, okay? One egg at a time. And whisk it. And then another one. And we wanna mix it until the mixture is smooth. Alright, so my mixture looks smooth already, okay? The reason why I mix my sugar together here with the wet ingredient, because my sugar is not that fine, but if you're using caster sugar, you can actually mix it with the rest of the dry ingredients, okay? Now, we want to add in the buttermilk. Again, if you do not have actual buttermilk where you live, then you can just use regular milk, okay? A whole milk or full cream milk. Now I just want to mix it until combined. Okay, now my wet ingredients are ready. I'm going to work on the dry ingredients. So I have 1 cup of all-purpose flour here. Now I'm going to add 1 cup of cornmeal. One cup of cornmeal, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and also 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. So if you are using whole milk instead of using buttermilk, then you wanna use 1 teaspoon of baking powder instead of baking soda, okay? So this baking soda is to cut the acidity from the buttermilk, all right? So 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda for 1 cup of buttermilk, but use 1 teaspoon of baking powder for 1 cup of whole milk. If you are using whole milk. Now I'm going to whisk these dry ingredients together. All right. Now I'm gonna combine the wet and the dry ingredients together. All right. By pouring the dry ingredients into the wet ingredients gradually. All right, not all at once. So do not expect the cornbread texture to be like a cake with light texture. Cornbread texture is gonna be dense. So don't worry about mixing this wet and the dry ingredients together. But you still wanna just mix this mixture just until combined or until you see only a few lumps left, okay? That's it, just like this. I see a little bit of lumps here, but it is totally fine. Okay. So I have my 8x8 pan here already lightly greased. Now I just need to pour my batter into my 8x8 pan. All right. Now just smooth the top. All right, now I wanna let my batter to sit for 3 minutes to let it settle before I bake it at 375 degrees Fahrenheit for 25 minutes to 35 minutes. So 3 minutes already, I'm going to bake it for 25 minutes first. All right, let me check. After 31 minutes. All right, so I have baked this cornbread for 31 minutes because after 25 minutes I checked, it was still kind of wet, my toothpick didn't come out clean, but now it comes out clean. Okay, so after 25 minutes I noticed that the surface, the top, was kind of getting brown already, so I had to cover with the foil before I put it back into the oven, okay, so that my cornbread top wouldn't be too brown when it's done baking. Before I let it sit, I'm going to brush the top with butter. I'm just using salted here because that's what I have ready. Just brush the top with butter. Salted or unsalted doesn't matter. But I'm using the salted one because I like the salted taste more. All right, so it's done now, okay? But you're gonna have to wait for 5 to 10 minutes to let it sit before you slice it and eat it, okay? So this is my cornbread. I actually already sliced, but I'm gonna try. You see, when I cut it, when I slice it,
It didn't crumble. Okay? It stick together. This is the kind of the cornbread that I like. It's not dry and it doesn't crumble.
So what do you think, Ma?
It doesn't crumble outside your mouth, but it melts inside your mouth.
Gimana, Mer? Enak gak, Mer? Mer, enak gak cornbread-nya?
So good.